Resources are a powerful feature in Godot. They can be easily created in the editor, save to disk, and store all sorts of useful information. Materials, sound effects, textures, all are resources and incredibly useful in their own way. But what if you can make your own? This isn't some hypothetical arcane power, but a real thing you can do, and rather easily too. In the editor, create a new script, set it to inherit from resource, and give it a class name. Now right-click in the editor, click new resource, and search for whatever you set the class name to be. Select the right resource, and give it a name. You just created a totally custom resource. But what can you actually do with this? Well, for starters, you can create export variables in your script to define custom data. Here's a statsheet resource that has export variables for health, attack, and defense. I can create as many of these as I want in the editor, change the values of their export variables, then assign them to enemies and NPCs in the game with ease. Anything you can create normally as an export variable will still work on custom resources, so get creative. You can even use other resources like materials and textures. Here's a resource that stores a bunch of materials and lets you pick a random one. Why would you want that? I have no idea, but you can do it. Just like every built-in resource, your custom resource is an object at runtime. So if you change the value of a variable in the resource, everything that uses that same resource will see the updated value. If we give our player a little stat boost, anything that references the stat sheet will see the increase as well. You can also define methods and signals on custom resources. For example, if you use the tool keyword at the top of your script, you can write methods that run in the editor. I use it in the statsheet resource to define a setget on the HP variable that lets me clamp it to a value between 0 and 255. Editor methods are nice, but let's take this resource functionality even further. For example, I have the shooter game with some test enemies. They're all instances of the same scene, but I can alter their mechanics with custom resources. Each enemy has an array of resources called death effects. When an enemy dies, they iterate over that array and call the trigger effect method on each resource that has it defined. Conveniently, I have a base enemy effect class that inherits resource and defines a trigger effect method. So if I want to create an effect that triggers when an enemy dies, I can just write a new custom resource that extends the enemy effect class. This one, for instance, is called Timed Explosion. It simply sets a timer and spawns an explosion effect on timeout. If I drop this resource onto an enemy's death effects variable in the inspector, they'll explode shortly after they die. The other enemies, however, won't because they don't have a timed explosion resource in their death effects. Even though all the enemies share the same scene, I can completely change how they behave using only custom resources. Of course, we can still store custom data on these behavior-defining resources with export variables. I'll create one on the timed explosion effect that lets me change the countdown time. Now in the editor, I can create multiple variations of the same effect. Hopefully, you're starting to see just how much custom resources can speed up your design process. Making new enemy varieties with this system is as easy as swapping some resources in the editor. I don't even need to script anything new if I've already programmed the resources that I want. Custom resources are clearly super easy to load and create in the editor, but they're also really easy to save as well. Take this save game custom resource I made that stores some player values like their position and rotation. We can actually set these values from a script at runtime, then save those changes by storing the resource on disk. Saving is as easy as calling resourceSaver.save, then passing a valid path and any resource instance as parameters. For example, I'm going to save this gameplay data to user/resourceExample/saveGame.tres and pass my save game resource. Make sure you include the file name and extension in the path. Loading that resource from disk later is done using the tried and true load method. Just call it and pass in the same path that you saved the resource to. So, to recap, when I want to save the game, I create an instance of my custom save game resource, set the position and rotation values I defined, and save it to disk using resourceSaver.save. Then, when I want to load it later, I grab whatever resource is stored on the same path using the load method, cast it to a save game resource, then set the player's position and rotation values to whatever is set on the loaded save game. Now I can open the game, walk around, click save, close the game, reopen it, then click load, and voila, we're right back where we saved. With custom resources, the only limitation is your imagination, and also the fact that you can't set custom resources as an export type yet in other scripts. That part still kind of sucks, though this might be resolved in Godot 4, we'll have to see. But anyway, the power of custom resources outweighs that limitation, and hopefully this video gave you some ideas on how you can integrate them into your own game.